Okay, so we're heading back to Harkon. Is that his name? Let him know. Well, he already knows by now that we found the Moth Priest. Rescued the Moth Priest from the Dawn Guard that were trying to do something to him. I don't understand the mirror-mirror universe in Skyrim, as far as
Looks like you had no trouble.
the Dawn Guard and the vampire clan.
The effects have already been felt. The Ice Runner has failed to dock on time. Without the lighthouse, the Ice Runner will have swung wide of the western shoal and run aground on the eastern coast. My sister Dija will be at the wreck with our Black Blood Marauders. She knows to expect you.
He looks pretty good for a vanilla
Get moving.
skinned
I'll see if I can't
Argonian
delay any patrols out there.
who's hot.
Dija and I are more like the representatives here.
He's
in
got
Solitude.
feathers
None
stuck
of
in
the
his
Black
head.
Bloods can show themselves without being arrested.
Normally, I think he wears a hat.
The Black Blood Marauders
A
are
leather helmet or
very
of some kind.
identifiable. I didn't want anyone thinking the Black Bloods were getting too bold.
But now he's hot.
Just leave.
So sometimes he's nice to me, and sometimes he says something rude when I'm getting ready to leave. So right now he's a rival. He's my rival. That means he's gonna kill me if, as long as the quest doesn't control his behavior. He will kill me on sight. Or, I didn't check, maybe he's just unaggressive. He's my rival, he wants to kill me, but he's unaggressive about it, so. That's almost like being passive-aggressive. But he's even worse, he's just unaggressive. Okay, off to the
Looking
castle.
Fire on a boat? Where are you headed? Climb on in and let's get this over with.
It's a lonely, how they say it? Anyway, it's a lonely ride to the castle,
what
that's
is
for
your
sure.
command?
I like this part. He talks to me like I've got him hypnotized because
Not
I do.
As much as I would like. Even after spending decades of my life in study of the Elder Scrolls, they remain a great mystery to me.
He calls me master and junk like that. Up there, Saran.
Oh, what is it?
She still has the same old eyeballs that I
How
gave her.
Next time.
Living here, I have access to magic I couldn't possibly imagine before.
I want her to have his eyeballs, so that she'll match
I'll make the necessary preparations for
the rest of these
the
vampires.
Presently,
as far as eyeballs go.
Speak with Fiora Bloodmouth. She has something for you.
Was Bloodmouth her name before she became a vampire?
Well done. Somehow I knew it would be you who found our moth priest. Yes, I see that. I trust his capture was not too difficult a task.
I like this part.
We both know that a band of fools with crossbows is no match for a scion of the ancient blood. I admit, I do not entirely understand your sense of humor. Your thrall awaits, and we have given him the Elder Scroll.
He calls him a thrall.
And let us hear the words of prophecy together.
This
well,
is all...
Well, where have you been, Vingalmo? Nose stuck in a book.
This is the second time I've played as a vampire.
Master.
So I don't know any of this quest dialogue. I don't remember half of it.
What is it that you need me to do?
It's been years since I've sided with the vampires.
I admit, I am looking forward to this.
He is totally under my spell.
Master. Now, if everyone will please be quiet, I must concentrate. I see a vision before me. An image of a great bow. I know this weapon. It is Oriole's bow. Now a voice whispers, saying, among the knight's children, a dread lord will rise. In an age of strife, when dragons return to the realm of men, darkness will mingle with light, and the night and the day will be as one.
Who's pushing me?
The words begin to shimmer and distort. But wait, there is more here. The secret of the bow's power is written elsewhere. I think there is more to the prophecy, recorded in other scrolls. Yes, I see them now. One contains the ancient secrets of the dragons, and the other speaks of the potency of ancient blood. My vision darkens, and I see no more. To know the complete prophecy, we must have the other two scrolls.
It's like he's shorter than me, just by a hair.
Not as useful as I would have liked. Even so, you did well. My traitor wife stole one of them away and then disappeared. As for the other, the last that I heard, it was lost in the bowels of a Dwemer ruin. It seems our work is not yet done. But I have waited this long, and we are so very close now. I can wait a bit longer. Life here has many advantages. Don't you agree?
Yeah, I'm so done with her eyeballs. She is going to have new eyeballs very soon.
That moth priest, Dexian, he said we needed two other Elder Scrolls. I think I know where we can start looking. Didn't want that lot getting wind of it, especially my father.
I don't want to hear about it. I want what I asked for.
It's not a question of trust. He's just obsessed with the prophecy. And from what I could tell, 1,000 extra years of obsession haven't made him any better. I should have found him a hobby. I don't even think he sees me as his daughter anymore. I'm just... a means to an end. We need to find my mother, Valerica. She'll definitely know where it is. And if we're lucky, she actually has it herself. The last time I saw her, she said that she'd go somewhere safe. Somewhere that my father would never search. Other than that, she wouldn't tell me anything. But the way she said it, someplace he would never search. It was cryptic, yet she called attention to it.
I need to go on YouTube and watch videos of people that have this Serana installed to see what she looks like with their ENB.
Maybe. What I can't figure out is why she said it that way. Besides, I can't imagine a single place my father would avoid looking. And he's had all this time, too. Any ideas? I doubt my mother would waste her time with those fools. They probably would have tried to kill her, and that has a way of souring relationships. Any other ideas? I don't think so. She said she wanted to stay awake in case the situation was resolved. It had to be one of us, and, well, she's so much more powerful than I am. It just made sense for her to be out here. Anything else? Wait, that almost makes sense. I used to help my mother tend a garden in the courtyard here. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place. Too peaceful. Oh, absolutely. But my mother's not a coward. That is, I don't think we'll actually trip over her there, but it's worth a look. Trust me, I lived here a very long time and I know every nook and cranny. There's an unused inlet on the northern side of the island that was used by the previous owners to bring supplies into the castle. An old escape tunnel from the castle exits there. I think that's our way in.
The previous owners? What, these vampires killed everyone who lived here?
Come on, it's just around the side.
And just let the castle go to ruin? There needs to be a mod that has the family that used to run this castle before the vampires took it over. That'd be a cool mod. And you have quests and things. Game of Thrones going on in here. I guess it would be a bunch of Nords living in this place. Or these are them. Since vampires live forever, these could be the people that lived in the castle before they all got infected.
I wish Orthiolf and Vingarmo would just get it over with and kill each other. Ugh, I'm tired of listening to them. You're going to kill a Dawnguard spy. But don't draw attention. Some kills are for fun, some for profit, and others are for sending messages. This one is a message. With any luck, he'll bleed to death before anyone notices. A cold corpse will say what we want. Better than a warm one. What do you think I mean? Don't make a big scene. Don't get caught. The corpse is to be the message, not the attack. Good.
She never looks at me. She's always staring at her feet. That just seems so weird.
Life here has many advantages. Don't you agree?
What about this
guy? I hope you find life in the castle to be to your liking.
I want
to
sell some stuff.
I don't have more to offer.
I don't know who in here sells the junk. Okay, this guy's got the junk.
Until next time.
Okay, so I...
Do you need something?
Switched out Serena's eyeballs. So now... She has the same eyeballs now... as... her dad.
What is it?
Her mom. And everyone else that's a vampire in the game.
Yes? I'm right behind you.
So, I just had to test out the glow. The glowiness... I mean, you could have too much glow for an eyeball, and it starts to get on your nerves looking at a vampire and their eyes glow too much. So it took some adjustments, tweaking here and there, till I finally got her eyeballs the way they're supposed to be.
Right behind you. All right, then. Any luck yet?
So now we're gathering up the stuff so that she can make the brew to open up the portal. She's giving me a hug before I do something stupid and get myself killed.
You did? Let me see them. I only know what she told me. She had a theory about soul gems, that the souls inside of them don't just vanish when they're used. They end up in the Soul Cairn. The Soul Cairn is home to very powerful beings. Necromancers send them souls and receive powers of their own in return. My mother spent a lot of time trying to contact them directly, to travel to the Soul Cairn itself.
Her eyes are looking too bright to
me. That circle in the center of the room is definitely some type of portal. If I'm reading this right, there's a formula here that should give us safe passage into the Soul Cairn. A handful of soul gem shards, some finely ground bone meal, a good bit of purified void salts. Oh, damn it. We're also going to need a sample of her blood, which, if we could get that, we wouldn't even be trying to do this in the first place. Not bad. We'd better hope that's good enough. Mistakes with these kind of portals can be gruesome. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Oh, good. Well then, let's head over to the portal vessel and I'll do the rest.
Oh, that's right. I'm a vanilla vampire, so my whatchamacallit. Vampire sight. It's timed, and
then
after
the rest
a while
is up to me.
Yes.
Are you ready to go?
Her eyeballs
I'm not
are
entirely
up.
Sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood.
We're not doing anything until we fix your eyeballs. My OCD.
Okay, here goes.
If I had OCD, it would be kicking in right now about her eyeballs.
By the way, my ancestors. Created a portal in the Soul Cairn. Incredible.
I'm already a vampire, so I don't think I have to worry about
I'm ready when you are.
My health draining when I go in the portal, do I? No. So let's go find her mom.
I was hoping it wouldn't smell this bad. Let's just find my mother and get out of here quickly.
Let's get a look at your eyeballs.
The dead who end up here for eternity.
Oh, she can hug me on the steps. Good.
Ugh, the smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly.
Anyway, I was lollygagging. I wanted to do all the things that I hadn't tried before.
Let's kill those keeper things and get back to the prison.
Okay, so we talked to the mom and now we're doing keeper stuff? Okay. So I fixed her eyeballs.
I can't believe we found my mother alive. Well, you know what I mean.
Her eyeballs, they don't glow anymore. They're painted very, very brightly, but they don't glow. so. Yeah, I'm gonna avoid him. I'm not doing his quest for a while. I just wanna do Advar, whatever that horse's name is, and the other one. That's it. What was the other quest? Not to die or something? No, the other quest was to kill those keeper things. Oh, I remember now. Yeah, the other quest was to get the 3 spell books. The Mist Man, the Bone Man, and the Wraith Man. The trick is to kill these things without making Srana go on fire like she is right now. She hates it when I make her alight.
The sooner we get out of this place, the better.
But she looks like she's in a good mood still, so. Sometimes she'll run away from me, and then I just have to do stuff on my own for a while. Why is this one? This one's always stuck in the ground, I don't know why. I have to click on it to make him wake up. His offset, or bounding box, or whatever it's called, was wrong when he got spawned. So he got spawned in the ground. Too low or too high? Probably too high. So he was just stuck in the ground, he couldn't move. Oops, I'm messing up here. I don't remember how those little lightning rods work. If you're supposed to pick up a black soul gem. Or put in a black soul gem. Use an empty one or use a filled one. Those lightning rods. I can't remember. Okay, so here's Soul Gem. Then bad guys start to show up.
Oh no, you don't.
Now Saran is out of the fight, so I'll fight for her. She comes back when the last enemy is killed.
Let's kill those keeper things and get back to the prison.
Let's.
The quicker we find the keepers, the quicker we can.
So I thought there'd be a soul gem up there. But I guess the soul gem you collect is on the Wraithman that spawns. Then I thought, well, maybe when I blew apart some Draugr with my sword and blasted the soul gem out of its container, and it's on the ground here somewhere.
I can't believe we found my mother alive.
So that's cool. You know, Serana's eyeballs, they're bright, they look like they're glowing, but they don't actually glow. If that makes sense. They're just painted. There's painted yellow eyeballs, that's it. I was surprised how easy it was to change your eyeballs. I just extracted the was it the DDS file? The image file from the Skyrim. I want to say it was the You Sleep patch. I want to say I found the eyeball there. But now that I think about it, I think I extracted the eyeball from the Dawnguard module. Yeah, that's what I did. I copied the generic vampire eyeball that comes with the Dawnguard DLC. I copied it into my customized Serana eyeball folder. Overwrote the eyeball image file that she was using. The dilated pupil with the red iris. Anyway, work like a champ. And then I told my Serana to not make her eyeballs glowy. Oh, there's one of the books. So this is that other quest I'm on where I'm collecting up the three books. Spell books. And as I learn the spells, so does Serana. But this is the place to come to if you want to get soul gems. The ghostly remains. You can refill on pretty much anything just going through ghostly remains. I don't think I have any mods that touch this area exactly. So I'm assuming this is gonna be like vanilla items that I'm picking up. But running around here, it reminds me of the Shimmering Isle. Is that what it's called? That plug-in before Oblivion. Oh, this guy's tough. I mean, this just seems like, a similar realm to where that Shigaro guy lived. Anyway, so I'm still just lollygagging. Oh, there's a keeper. This looks like a place where a keeper lives. Oh, yeah. It was called the Shivering Isles. and it was Shagoroth. And he had bluish looking women and gold colored women roaming around. Very cool looking. Anyway. But he's just sitting right there. Didn't have a chance. So I removed what? The Sky Test mod? It made all these things tougher to fight. So now they're just vanilla that I'm fighting. I just want to get through this. So I can get the Ariel's bow. So I could get my achievement for Daedric weapons, even though Ariel's bow is not a Daedric weapon. I'm still liking the environment out here with this ENB that I'm using. Even got there's like a overcast, there's fog, there's sunshine, there's just this dark ominous look about the place. Depending on time of day, just the random number generator decides what kind of weather is going to be in this place. And I've been finding out that a lot of these glowy things that are on the ground, if you stand on them, they sort of heal you up. Still not sure exactly how they work. If I stand on one, it will heal me up quick. But then I have so many perks. If I stand still, I'll heal up quick too, so I don't even have to be on one of them. So it's hard to tell if the thing's doing something or not. Well, this place looks important. I think I've been here already. I don't see any loot. As long as I get the 3 books, I'm good. Then I have the spells I need. And I don't have to keep running around here looking for stuff. For now, we're just waiting for Serana. Oh, here she comes. Let's go kill those keeper things. Usually when I come in here, I just kill everything. Where'd you come from? But this time, I was getting my ass kicked. I must be getting hit by 2 things at once or something. I just assume that Serana will kill the thing coming out of the ground so I don't have to deal with it. But the thing just backhanded me. It swings its weapon. Oh, there's 2 of them. Oh man, that's what's going on. There were 2 of them giving me a backhanded attachment. Oh, someone saved me. Yeah. The keeper might have some sort of survival mode kicking. When its health goes down a certain amount, then all of a sudden it goes into like a berserk mode.
Stay on your guard. There we go.
Whoa. That one exploded pretty big. Somehow I got somebody. Oh. She's in recovery mode.
I'm not gonna die like this.
That is cool. I don't know what she's all about in my game, but it's kind of cool. There's no facial expressions as a vampire lord. The face mesh doesn't do anything. So there's no visual cues of any kind. Whoa. Oh, that nearly kills her. On your feet, soldier! See, this is the place to be if you want to get soul gems that are filled. And she was pretty close to ground zero, so it might be a while to get her to heal back up. There we go. Okay, she's all doing her reset. System reboot, reset, whatever it is she does. Hey. As long as she's solid, I don't care. If she has that, I'm not a solidity thing going on, then I have to go back to a save where she was working. That hasn't been an issue so far in this playthrough. She's worked like a champ, considering all the mods I have installed. What is this? This is teleport? Yeah. I didn't die, apparently. Okay. I think I was up here before, wasn't I? Maybe not. I should kill all the things before Serana got up here. That caused her to go into hibernation mode again. But that's weird that she didn't follow me up here. What? She must have other things on her mind. I can't move. I keep picking up something that's... Eat all the weight. Eat it. So how do I get back down? Just jump? I just find a nice, soft, cushy landing spot somewhere.
The barrier should be gone now. Let's head back.
I'm looking at her eyeballs. Thinking, oh, she needs to change her eyeballs again. Right after this video, I think I updated the vampires again in my game. Went back to an old mod I used a year ago. I'm looking ahead in my footage and I see Valerica is naked. In a thumbnail up ahead. Guess that's weird. Which means I have to do editing of some kind for this video. This way. Oh, okay, so Valerica was getting raped by the dragon until she didn't. Maybe she still was. No, she ran off. Still in the fight. I always forget that he sort of dissolves away. Oh, what's going on with my frame rate?
Come on, she's leading us to the scroll.
Volumes written on Durnavir alleged that he can't be slain by normal means. It appears they were mistaken. The soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnavir's physical form while he reconstitutes himself. Minutes? Hours? Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll, and you can be on your way.
She kept wandering around. I had to keep chopping out certain frames. Otherwise, YouTube will flag the video, and I have to start all over, getting rid of videos that YouTube kept flagging.
As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Harkon. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the tyranny of the Sun to fruition. I appreciate your concern for me, but Serana is all that I care about. You must keep me safe at all costs. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted. No matter what he promises, he'll deceive you in order to get what he wants. And promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left.
I like how the dialogues are slightly different with the parents and with Serana, depending on the path you choose as a vampire or as a member of the Dawn Guard. Because the outcome's going to be the same in the end. But the way to get there is different. So that's interesting. Hello?
Stay your weapons.
We're best of friends
I would
now.
Speak with you, Quinarin.